Today, we're going to be using proximal priority optimization to train an AI how to play 3D Pong. PPO is an algorithm that falls under the broader umbrella of reinforcement learning. Reinforcement or reward-based learning is pretty straightforward. If the agent does something that you like, it gets a tasty treat. If the agent does something that you don't like, it gets kicked in the ribs. For example, if the agent hits the ball with his paddle, treat. If the agent misses the ball and loses a point, second degree assault. Using these rewards and punishments, the agent will go through a series of trial and error to develop a set of rules or a policy that will help it maximize the amount of rewards that it can get over a period of time. To get started on building a Pong Alcatraz, I just made a basic 3D room in Unity with some transparent material, played around with the physics a little bit so they don't have to deal with Newton's apple bullshit, and then just did some scripting. But the whole thing's pretty straightforward. The paddles can be moved independently, they can't move through walls, the ball never gets stuck, the box never falls apart. Unfortunately, a prefer at my house isn't just a big pile of smoldering coal, so I had to reduce the number of game instances from 224 down to 9. Now keep in mind that each of these game instances contains 2 agents, so even though we only have 9 on the screen, we are simultaneously training the same agent 18 times per cycle. The paddles themselves can only be moved along the Y and the Z axis, with the X axis being the space between each paddle. Each paddle is attached to the same agent but are rewarded independently. If paddle A hits the ball behind paddle B, paddle A is rewarded and paddle B is punished. This lets the agent play against itself and have a larger pool of data to learn from. At least that's the way they're supposed to work. When I was writing the code for this the first time, I accidentally started punishing the winning player, so I spent an hour training the agent to lose as efficiently as it possibly could. But once I fixed that, the results started to improve massively. Who would have thought? With PPO, we do all of our training in steps, where each step is an interaction with the agent and its environment. The agent observes the current state of the environment. In our case, the observation of the player's current location and how fast it's moving in a direction. We also have the ball's location, direction, and velocity. In total, this adds up to 15 observations per step, because each observation that we have is just a 3-dimensional vector. Based on the game state and the current policy, the agent will take an action, which in our case is the movement of the paddle. We allow the agent to take 2 continuous actions, vertical and horizontal, where each action array can be -1, 0, or 1, allowing for a movement in 8 directions. The environment will respond to the agent's actions, either punishing or rewarding it depending on the outcome. The agent records this experience and uses the information to update its policy for future steps. A famous usage of PPO that you might actually be aware of happened back in 2019, when OpenAI 5's Dota team won 2 back-to-back games against professional players. The AI team was reported to have a whopping 45,000 years of equivalent Dota playing experience. Now, this whole thing was then in just 10 months, using advanced learning techniques and parallelization. Our neural network is obviously nowhere near as complex as the Dota team's, with 15 input neurons, which are observations, 3 hidden layers with 512 neurons each, and 2 output neurons, which is just the direction that the paddle will move in when the action is taken. That's a total of 1,553 total neurons in each of our little paddles that we have in the scene here. Kind of cool when you think about it. To get the same number of neurons in our project as a standard human brain, we would have to increase the number of instances that we have by 55,376,690. I couldn't even reliably run more than 9 instances of this game on my own machine. But if we convinced every single person in Myanmar to run one of these Pong games, we'd be within striking distance. It's a little bit less cool when you think about it that way. Now, let's get into the project stuff. Agents are very sensitive to rewards and parameters, so here are just a few things that I've played around with. We've got batch size, buffer size, learning rate, learning schedule, beta. We've got tastier treats, steel cap boots, letting them explore, whipping them into drones. You kind of get the point. There's a lot of little moving parts, and each individual part plays its own role in the outcome of the training. My motivation for the end goal of the training for the agents also changed a lot throughout the project, which slowed things down. I originally thought that I wanted an infinite rally, and then I thought I wanted to make the perfect Pong bot that always tries to win. When I enabled explicit self-play, with such the agent play against itself and compete against itself, I would find that the agent would find some pretty cool moves to take, as in hitting it with the edge of the paddle so that it goes in a weird direction, but it wasn't really good to watch because often it would be over in 1, 2, maybe 3 hits. I tried increasing the speed of the ball every time it got hit so that it would encourage a longer rally, but then the agents wouldn't be able to keep up after a period of time. I couldn't really get the speed right on that to make it interesting because often it would only go for 5, maybe 10 tries. I settled on the infinite rally agent and here are the results. You can see here that the paddle is a little bit jittery. This is because the agent is making a decision every single update, and unlike a human who would just hold down an arrow key, it does make the decision based on the information that it currently has for the step that it is running on. Now, there is potential to improve upon this by balancing the reward system and potentially encouraging the paddle to stay still for as long as possible, but for the purpose that we have, it works really well and I think it's pretty cool.